Hello everybody, welcome back to another video. Today we're going to be covering regression. We're going to be using two data sets, which as you can see on the screen, and I will be sharing these to you via Google Drive, I think. But whatever it is, it'll be in the description, so you can easily download it. It'll probably also be in the website, so be sure to check that out. Now let's move quick. I've got two of the data sets I just showed you, but I really want to explain both the data sets. The first data set is a years by salary data set, and this is what I like to call a linear regression data set, a data set which is like perfect for linear regression. Why, you might ask? Because it's pretty obvious to know that the more years you work, the higher you're gonna get paid. Because with years comes expertise, experience, and a lot of different things. But even if you look at it from this trend point of view, usually, if you can see over here, the salary does decrease, even when you have more years. But usually, if you look at the data, then you would see that with more experience comes a higher salary compared to a lower experience. So let's get to plotting this. I'm gonna open a graphing tab, and on the graphing tab, so let's first show you guys what a scatter plot is. Our two variables were years of experience, and based on that, you're gonna give people their salary. Bam. Now, what this is called is a scatter plot. We are doing it using the visualization tab, I think. That's what I like to call it, at least. But this is what is called a scatter plot, and it lets you basically see all points in action. I could like basically even switch the axes to get different kinds of curves, etc., and change the variables. But so what we're gonna do is perform regression on this. I'm gonna do that with the command menu 4-6, which opens you up to a tab full of regressions. As I mentioned before, it should be a linear regression in this case, because with higher years of experience you get more salary. So as you can see, linear regression, it does fit, but if you're looking at statistics, you're never going to get anything at 100%, or you're not going to get any kind of data set where one line runs through everything perfectly. That is very, very, very rare. If you do any kind of statistics, you know, it's really hard to get any kind of data like that. So considerably or comparatively, this regression line is a strong fit, and I'll show you why. So you can do that with opening another tab in the calculator section. I think I went too quick, but if you head into this section, then you can do regression here. So you can do menu 4-1 and do regression here. Now the advantage of doing it on this page is that you get to look at two values, which I will be discussing. So you just pop in years of experience and salary, and bam, you get a m x plus b, right? And you also get r square, r residual, a lot of different things. Now what I want to cover with these is what they actually do, the functions. Mx plus b is, I think we all of us know, that's the form of the linear equation. But r square is basically, it's a statistical measure, and r square is also known as the coefficient of determination. And it says that, and it tells you how close your data is to the regression model. So the R square is best when it's closest to one. We say closest to one because even if you look at this data set, you probably will never find a data set where all points will be exactly in a straight line or curved, because we're going to do quadratic, which you can see later. And the next thing here you would see is residual. Residual is known as the vertical distance between a data point and the regression line. So there are even things called residual plots, and therefore each data point, so like this point, it's a data point, and the distance between whatever value of y you get for this x, for 4.1, would be the residual for that point. So you get individual residuals for each of them, and over here it just gives you the mean of all of that, which is useful. If you can see, look at this big value that you get. That's because it doesn't round it off completely and gives you the full thing. I mean, it is a calculator. Now the advantage of doing linear regression here also is that you can now easily plot it on a graphing tab, like so. If you look at it, we saved it as F1. So if you pop up F1, you should easily be able to plot this linear regression. I'm just gonna zoom out a bit. That's the wrong regression line. Yeah, right. So yeah, you can zoom out, but another technique which you could use is Many4A, which I like to use. It just basically puts it nicely for you. This is, we have really high values here because I took salary, and obviously salary is a really high Y value. So yeah, based on the X. The next data set we're taking is an angle by distance for a baseball game, which I found. Now I think probably all of you would know, if you play any kind of sport like football or swimming, you're always told to keep your angle or shot or anything like that at a certain angle. Anything more or less usually gives you less of whatever you want. Less distance or less speed or less power, whatever it is. But you always know that there is a certain angle or place that you have to do it in. And I think the same thing applies for baseball. In this case, if you look at it, this data set, it has, so based on angles, you're going to get the distance. But if you notice, obviously, if you hit the baseball very high, then you won't get a really good distance. And if you don't swing it to an angle high enough, then you aren't going to get any distance either. So basically, this data, if you will see, somewhere in the middle here is where the maximum is, or where you can get the maximum data. We're going to follow the same procedures. We're going to first check it in a visualization lab by getting a scatter plot of angle and degrees by distance. And as I told you, there is some kind of maximum around there. We can estimate it, we can't exact it right now because we don't have the plot. And that's why, again, a disadvantage of this interface, you can't actually play with the graph. Even if I do menu 4 6 and I get some kind of regression, which in this case is quadratic, then I really can't play or get the maximum point or do any kind of extrapolation with this. So again, we're just gonna follow the same procedure. I'm gonna speed through it this time, I think, because you could just watch it. And I will definitely be putting the shortcuts up on the screen. If you do quadratic regression, again, I already explained what R square and residual are. And you do know what A, B, C are. Everyone knows the basic quadratic regression. You can go over here in a graphing page, and we saved this one as F2, I believe. And yeah, bam, we get it. The next thing that we're gonna do is we're gonna analyze this curve. So we're gonna zoom out. So if we zoom out, we're probably gonna see this. And I'm gonna do extrapolation with these curves. I'm gonna probably predict something, maybe the intersection, but that's just 0, 0 in this case, so we really don't have anything powerful over here. We would usually, but we don't really have anything powerful there. So what I want to do is press command T, that's command or control based on a Windows or Mac, and based on the function. So F1, which was the linear model, and F2, which is the quadratic model. And I can go through this and find any value of y for any value of x. The same thing can be done if you just press command, he will exit the table. And for any value of y for which we want x, we probably, the best way to do it is to just draw a horizontal line and then find the intersection. Intersections will be covered in the next video, but I can teach you how to draw a horizontal line. Now, horizontal lines are always measured by y equals to x or something. So we just press like y equals 10. And we can just find the intersection, which will be done in the next video. Be sure to watch that. And yeah, we're done with the regression. Do doctor telling me that I'm insane, man? I wanna rob a bank, spread the money through the streets, walk up to a stranger's dream, stick them up, please. But I'm too worried about